Thousands of civilians have fled the militant-held enclave in eastern Syria ahead of the coalition offensive that began last week. Among them are members of Islamic State families, including this young widow.
I came here without knowledge, and knowledge very important in Islam. And I didn't regret because this makes me experience to be strong and to be mother and to be very strong.
Observers say more than 20,000 people so far have fled the area comprised of two villages on the border with Iraq, and smaller groups were still trickling out from the village of Bahuz on Sunday.
There is a great displacement, and look how people are leaving. And we slow down shooting so that we do not hurt civilians.
The arrivals undergo an initial security check outside Bahuz to separate civilians from Islamic State members. Civilians are then moved to a displacement camp outside the fighting zone. A man from Ireland has been detained as suspected jihadist.
We thought the more kids we will have, maybe we will have the more women and kids. If you go as a big group, this will be less dangerous. Maybe they're not, because they would see so many people, and especially with the kids crying, maybe they would not harm us.
Many people fleeing the area are foreigners.
There are all kinds of people here. There are many Arabs, foreigners in great numbers. Houses do not accommodate them. They're in the streets, the tents, and trenches.
Kurdish-led Syrian Democratic Forces say militants are increasingly using civilians as human shields to block their advance. Islamic State fighters are putting up fierce resistance in the village of Bahuz, their final holdout in eastern Syria.
Currently, we are at the edge of Bahuz. Hopefully, during this period, we'll be able to liberate it from the Islamic State group. We have high hopes and high morale. We won't return home until we have liberated it completely from the forces of terrorism.
Islamic State once controlled large swaths of Iraq and Syria, but its self-proclaimed caliphate has been dismantled through a concerted international effort in the past few years. The extremist group still holds small pockets of land in both countries and is capable of inflicting heavy casualties on the attacking forces. Zlatica Hoke, VOA News, Washington.